And today I shall discuss dramatic monologue. See, dramatic monologue is also prescribed into your syllabus, not as a term but a few poems. They are in the form of dramatic monologue. Some poems are like monologue. If they are not dramatic monologue, they are dramatic lyrics. If they are not dramatic monologue or dramatic lyric, they are interior monologue. So this form is very important as far as your syllabus is concerned in BA2. आपके BA2 के syllabus के लिए dramatic monologue form बहुत important है. So let me tell you what is a dramatic monologue. Okay, so dramatic monologue is a kind of poem which is generally written in the form of a speech, and this speech is of an individual character. Now don't get confused, dramatic monologue is written in the form of a speech, and this speech is delivered by a character, an individual person. It is not like drama. Drama has also speeches, but this is the complete speech of one person. So it is not written like X person is saying something and then the speech is written, no, like that. But it is a kind of a speech. As see into the form, the title of the form itself, dramatic monologue, it means that it has some elements of drama. And in drama, what do you find? You find speech, you find action, and in drama generally you find the unknown presence of the audience, because drama jo hota hai darshakon ke liye perform kiya jata hai. So if you remember these 3-4 points, then you can easily understand what is a dramatic monologue. So a dramatic monologue is a kind of a speech or a kind of poem that is more in the form of drama. The character who is not necessarily, who is not, you can see, he is not the poet himself. The character is completely a third person, remember that. In many of the lyrics, when we are reading, we are studying, we are interpreting it, appreciating it, whatever you call it, we most of the times believe that the character of the poem is the poet himself, or the narrator of the poem is the poet himself. But in dramatic monologue, he is not the poet himself. This point you have to keep in your mind. Now, it is a kind of narrative, seems to be a narrative, because the character tells the story in the form of a speech. But at the same time, you will find the gestures, the movement that he makes or she makes, means the characters who, the character who is mentioned into a dramatic monologue, he moves, he acts like a characters into a drama they act. So you will find that it has a form of silent action. The character of the dramatic monologue is acting like the given role. Then it is generally trying to see what? Through the dialogues, it is trying to look into the deeper inner consciousness or psychology of the character. Most of the dramatic monologues, that is why they are called character analysis, because through the speeches that character is delivering, he is making, readers are to understand the inner motive of why he is doing this or why he is saying this. So it is much more psychological into nature. And the next point that is very important, again, how do we guess? that there is somebody who is listening. In a dramatic monologue, it is also necessary there that there should be a silent listener, the auditor, the person who would be listening to the speeches of this character. So I gave you a few points. It is a kind of a speech. It tells a story in the form of a speech. It is psychological into nature, and the character of the dramatic monologue is not the poet himself at any cost. It is dramatic, you see, because the character performs, or he has some action and he shows some gesture. There is a silent listener. It looks into the inner consciousness, inner psychology of the character, and it looks into the psychology of the character in order to know the motives behind why the character is making such statements and what kind of person he is or she is. These are a few important characteristics of a dramatic monologue. Let's come to the title again. It's a dramatic and monologue. What is the meaning of monologue? Logos means study or speech. Logos has many meanings, and mono means one. So from the title itself, it is very clear that in this kind of poem, one person will be speaking. At the same time, he will be acting like people or characters who do action or they perform roles on stage into drama. So dramatic monologue. I hope that you have got all these points. So a dramatic monologue is this kind of poetry. This was first introduced in Italy, as some critics believe that Dante Alighieri was the first poet to use dramatic monologue. But it was perfected by Robert Browning, who is prescribed into your syllabus. Prospice is the poem which is prescribed into your syllabus. So Robert Browning is popularly known as the person or the poet who has written good dramatic monologues, and he has the skill, okay, the authority to write dramatic monologues in a very successful way. He has written My Last Duchess, he has written Fra Lippo Lippi, he has written Porfiria's Lover, he has written Last Ride Together, he has written Andrea del Sarto. These are some dramatic monologues that Robert Browning has written, and he has really accomplished the skill of writing dramatic monologues. Okay, I give you a few examples how these characteristics are understood. One good poem, I think it is whether prescribed into your syllabus or not, it is written by Robert Browning, and the title of the poem is My Last Duchess. There is a duke, and duke's wife is duchess, okay. So this duke has murdered his wife. I will tell you how he does that. There is another neighbor king who has sent the proposal of his daughter to this duke, who is a widower now, and this conversation starts from the beginning. And see what this duke is saying, Duke of Ferrara. See that portrait painted on the wall means that it is using an imperative sentence. Imperative sentence mein kya hota hai? You give order, you give request, you suggest somebody. It means that there is someone who is listening you. For example, you say, bring a glass of water. What does it mean? It means that there is someone who is listening you, and he or she is supposed to bring a glass of water for you. In the same way, this Duke is saying, look at the portrait painted on the wall. It means that he is addressing someone who is not speaking, who is silent, but he is listening and he is to look at the portrait, the painting of his wife. So in this way, we understand that there is a listener. There is a silent auditor or interlocutor who is listening the speech of this character. So as I said, it is a speech, there is a silent speaker. You will guess the presence of the listener through the statements, through the speeches when he is addressing. Some adjectives would be there, some demonstrative pronouns will be there, and through those demonstrative pronouns you would come to know that somebody is listening, koi sun raha hai. And see, he tells why or how he murdered his wife, and in a very polite way he tells that his wife was very beautiful, the last duchess was so beautiful, and she was so friendly to everyone. Anyone who went and met her and offered any bunch of you can say twigs or any flower, she smiled. And she smiled in the same way as she smiled to her husband. And then one day, what her husband did to her, he put the silence on all her smiles. He did something and she smiled her last. See, what does it mean? He was jealous. He is not saying that he was jealous, but he is saying that his wife was smiling on everybody in the same way as she was smiling on him. She was so much friendly to all other people as she was friendly to him. So he did not murder. He silenced her smile. It means that he murdered. जब उसकी वो last smile की और वो smile करना ही बंद कर दी, it means that he got her murdered. And he moves from one place to another. First in the painting, it begins with the painting, and then it comes to fixing the marriage proposal by securing a huge dowry. And he tells what he got. He brings that messenger or the person who brought proposal for new marriage to this Duke. He shows that these are the objects that he found into the last marriage in the form of dowry. So why is he showing all those things that he found into marriage with the last Duchess? Because he expects more dowry. इतना तो मेरे पास है ही, अब इससे ज्यादा आप देंगे तो हम दोबारा शादी करेंगे. बट ही डजंट से दैट ही नीड्स और ही इज डिमांडिंग फॉर मोर डाउरी, बट ही इज शोविंग बिकॉज ही इज एक्सप्रेसिंग हिज मोटिव टू लेट हिम अंडरस्टैंड दैट इफ यू आर ऑफ दिस स्टैंडर्ड एंड यू कैन ऑफर मी दिस मच एज वेल, ओनली देन यू शुड थिंक दैट दिस मैरिज इज गोइंग टू consummate, I mean this proposal is going to become fixed. This is how the character analysis, the deeper psychological aspect, why this character is behaving in this, what is the motive behind what he is saying and what he is doing, is understood. Character will not say anything directly, but through the speeches, through the sentences, we are to understand what is the motive behind it. Okay, so this is a dramatic monologue. Now I would like to distinguish dramatic monologue from other you can say terms or other forms that I mentioned, which are very much similar to dramatic monologue, but they are not dramatic monologue. One is dramatic lyric. See, what is the slight difference between dramatic monologue and dramatic lyric? All things are there. as I have already mentioned, a lyric is a subjective form of poetry. So in a dramatic lyric, the character is the poet himself. Remember this thing. Because lyric is subjective and lyric is a personal expression of the poet's own feelings and emotions, so dramatic lyric is having all these things. It is written in the form of dialogue. There is someone, speech, there is someone who is silently listening, and we understand the presence of that person through some statements or some demonstrative words, and it also shows the inner consciousness of the character or the poet. But in this dramatic lyric, the character of the poem is the poet himself. So what is the difference between dramatic monologue and dramatic lyric? In dramatic monologue, the character is not the poet, and in dramatic lyric, the character is the poet himself. Now let us come to interior monologue. What is an interior monologue? It is again a monologue, like a dramatic monologue. One person is speaking and there is someone who is listening, and the presence of that someone is again understood through the speeches that this character makes. But now this is not dramatic, this is interior. This is the difference. What is dramatic? That can be performed, that can be acted with action. What is interior? Here it happens in the mind of the character. Actually, the character is thinking to do all those things which he is saying. He is not doing anything. Everything is happening where? Inside the inner stage, inner consciousness of that character. He is not doing, but he is thinking. So all story that he is going to tell is not being performed with action, as the character in dramatic monologue is doing. Like he is saying, somebody, look at the wall, that is the portrait of my last Duchess. And then he brings that person to show the Neptune's statue of Neptune and other precious metals that he got in the form of dowry. So it is showing that he is moving into his own palace or into his own castle or house, home, whatever you call it, and from one place to another he is moving in order to show him. So it is a kind of dramatic action. Movement itself shows that you are performing something. But in interior monologue, the character is not doing anything at all. He is just sitting and planning and telling you. Now I come to the examples. See, Wordsworth has written Tintin Abbey. And in Tintin Abbey, Wordsworth himself is telling about what he has felt when he visited Tintin Abbey 5 years ago, and what he is feeling right now when he is visiting the same place after 5 years. So Tintin Abbey is a dramatic lyric because the poet himself is the character of this poem. And the third point is that there is a listener, the sister Dorothy Wordsworth. Wordsworth's sister Dorothy Wordsworth is there as a listener. So it also has a listener. So it can be called a dramatic lyric because it has all the four activities, all the properties of a dramatic monologue. But the only difference is that character is the poet himself. In dramatic lyric and in dramatic monologue, character is not the poet himself. And the best example of interior monologue is the love song of J. Alfred Prufrock by T.S. Eliot. You will read this love song into your syllabus. And in this whole poem, Prufrock is not doing anything at all. But after reading this poem, you will find that Prufrock has planned to do so many things. It will seem like he is doing something. But ultimately at the end you will come to know that all these things are happening inside the mind of Prufrock. Prufrock ke dimag mein sab kuch chal raha hai. So in dramatic monologue, again, what happens? The character is saying something, telling something at the same time. He is performing. He is moving from one place to another. So there is a dramatic action into his behavior. But in interior monologue, character is sitting at one place. He is not doing anything practically, but it seems that he is telling something in the form of dialogue, and there is someone who is listening. And in Love Song of J.L. Pratt, you will, in the first line, you will come to know who is the listener. He says, "Let us go then, you and I, when the evening is spread in the sky, like a patient etherize upon a table." So let's say two lines. "Let us go then, you and I. You is also there, I is also there. And who is you? You is nobody than the other self of Prufrock himself." We always feel divided into two selves, two parts, two consciousnesses. Kabhi hum log feel karte hain, hum kuch chahte hain aur hamara other self kuch chahta hai aur hum apne aap se baat karte hain. Prufrock is talking to himself and he say, "Let us go then, you and I." So you is there, Prufrock's other self is listening to him. So there is again a listener, but this listener is inside the mind of the character himself. And again, Prufrock is not T.S. Eliot. So this is the difference between dramatic monologue, dramatic lyric, and interior monologue. Let me come to other forms which are very similar, literary devices which are very similar, but they are not dramatic monologue. And what is the difference between them? There is one more, two more terms. One is soliloquy, soliloquy, soliloquy. So soliloquy is a kind of literary device which is used into drama properly. Remember that. When I say drama properly, means it occurs into drama only. What is soliloquy? Soliloquy is a speech delivered by one character. As you say, it is monologue, dramatic monologue. Here is also one character, but don't get confused. In soliloquy, the character is speaking his inner mind, whatever he is thinking, on the stage when no actor, other actor is present except the character himself. So no other character is on the stage, only the person who is speaking what he is thinking on the stage loudly is present on the stage. मतलब कहने का कि ड्रामा में कोई एक कैरेक्टर, जब सारे कैरेक्टर जो है स्टेज से चले जाते हैं, तो अकेले खड़ा होकर के अपने मन की बात बोलता है. एंड देर इज नो लिसनर इन सोलिलिक्की. रिमेंबर दैट. दिस इज व्हाट दैट डिस्टिंग्विशेस सोलिलिक्की फ्रॉम ड्रामेटिक मोनोलॉग और ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ मोनोलॉग्स, दैट देर इज नो लिसनर. द कैरेक्टर इज अलोन ऑन द स्टेज. An audience is there, we don't count it. So soliloquy is what? Soliloquy is used in drama when a character is speaking whatever he is thinking into his mind, when all other characters have left the stage, he is alone on the stage. So this is soliloquy. And there is another literary device that is called aside, A-S-I-D-E. Aside is again speech of one person on stage, but it is little bit typical to understand. Please pay attention. In this literary device aside, A-S-I-D-E, the character speaks whatever he is running into his mind when all characters or other characters are already there on the stage. But the issue is that, the technicality is that, other characters are not supposed to be hearing this speech or listening to this speech. They will be present, they will hear it, yes, but that will not affect the dialogue, the character, or you can see speeches of other character. That is not part of the conversation of the drama. That is part of the inner thought of the drama, or means character. And that is why you might have seen that when an aside is spoken, the character who is speaking, he uses his hand like this. It means that no other person is concerned with this. It is the inner thought of the character. Let me give you a very practical example. आप लोग अपने दोस्तों में बात करते हैं, लेकिन बात करते आपके दिमाग में कुछ ऐसी बात आती है जो अपने दोस्तों को नहीं बताते हैं. But that comes in your mind. Maybe your friend is trying to become smart and you're saying yes, yes, yes to convince him or to just let him feel that you are not opposing him. But into your mind you are already opposing him. So how will you say this on the stage? आप अपने माइंड को पढ़ते हैं ना, उस माइंड में जो रहता है आपके चलता है, वो आपके साइड के जो आपके आसपास के फ्रेंड्स हैं वो उसे कंसर्न नहीं होते, उन्हें पता नहीं होता आप दिमाग में क्या सोच रहे हैं. इन द सेम वे अ साइड इज यूज्ड ऑन ड्रामा बिकॉज द ड्रामाटिस्ट वॉन्ट्स टू लेट द ऑडियंस नो वॉट दिस कैरेक्टर इज थिंकिंग वेन ही इज in dialogue or he is talking to other characters on the stage. That is why in aside, again, despite being all characters present on the stage or other characters being present on the stage, they are not concerned that they are listening it. So soliloquy and aside, they have differences. In soliloquy, nobody is present, so nobody is listening, only the character is speaking. And in aside, everybody is present or other characters are present, but they are not listening it again. They will just remain silent and they will not make any gesture on the stage. Only the person who is speaking his thoughts, his mind, he will say and he will use this gesture. He will put his hands near his mouth. It shows that other people should. जैसे कान में फुसफुसाने के लिए आप ऐसे करते हैं ना. In that way he is telling the audience, audience ko batata hai ki uske dimag mein kya chal raha hai. So this is aside. So these all 4-5 terms, they are quite interlinked, okay, but they have differences. You may not find example of soliloquy in your this semester, I mean this year, second year, but you have found soliloquy of Lady Macbeth when you were reading Macbeth. When Lady Macbeth was reading loudly, when she found the letter of Macbeth that Duncan is coming and she is writing something to excite, to provoke Macbeth to kill Duncan. See, at that moment nobody is on stage, only Lady Macbeth is there. Do you remember that speech?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that is what? That is soliloquy. Nobody is on the stage and character is speaking loudly whatever comes into her mind. Her mind, you can say. And I don't recollect examples from the Macbeth drama about aside, but aside you can also understand in this way. And all characters are there, but they are not supposed to be hearing that speech, a side speech that is already always written into in brackets, and in bracket it is written aside, that this is not supposed to be heard by other characters, and that does not affect the discussion that is going on. So these are things that I wanted to discuss and differentiate in drama, so dramatic monologue, in dramatic lyric, dramatic other devices like soliloquy and aside, at the same time interior monologue. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so thank you for today.